In this lesson from the first letter of Peter, we have in juxtapose here one of those the great mysteries of the Christian life, also one of his great joys, which is that it has both the future and the present aspect. In a sense, that when he speaks about having our an inheritance, that is, you know, that, and again, that's the language of inheritance is the language of Israel. And in the Old Testament, the inheritance was the land of Israel. Your inheritance from your family was that family farm that was the future of your lineage, was based on that land and what it produced. And so the image of inheritance was, you know, to give your children a rich inheritance was to give them fruitful land, like a fruitful farm with lots of flocks and fertile ground. That was a rich inheritance because it could feed you into the future. It had the resources to provide you a future full of joy and new life. Again, in the Old Testament, understood literally as children, as, you know, being fed and having more children, that's the Old Testament kind of anticipation of the new inheritance that we receive in Christ. And now in Christ, our inheritance is not a piece of real estate, but it is a relationship with the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, a relationship that is indeed rich in what it can produce. It is rich in its provision for a future full of joy and full of new life. Now not measured in biological progeny, but new life measured in our capacity to love and serve others, our capacity to bring others to a place of flourishing. That's our inheritance. And in some ways, with the understanding of the Christian life, both through Paul, when he talks about the down payment or the seal of the Holy Spirit, bring us into a new life in Christ, and here in the witness of St. Peter in his first letter, that you have this inheritance that's prepared for you. It says imperishable, undefiled, unfading, kept in heaven, which is a way of speaking about God's future, right? It is kept in heaven. It's in a sense in the God place that into which we are moving through our lives into eternity. So it's kept in the safest possible place in the hands of God and his future, which human beings can't even conceive of, let alone try to rob or steal or destroy. So we know we will receive that inheritance, that relationship, which is God's gift to us, a gift that is irrevocable, a gift that cannot be spoilt even by our failures, as long as we trust God to give it to us and seek to have that reality fill our lives in the present. And so then we live our lives it says then at the end of this passage, says, for you are receiving, that's kind of a present tense, but a process. You are receiving, not you have received, as if it's already ours now, but it's not, it also, he doesn't say you will receive, as if it's all in the future, but you are receiving the outcome of your trust, the salvation of your souls, that we are in the process of being made new, of being saved, of being made a part of God's people, his transformed humanity. And we're in the process of that, as we learn, in a sense, to work the land, just as, you know, a farm boy is apprenticed to his father, the farmer, and learns how to plow fields, how to milk the cows, how to, you know, gather in crops, all those farm chores, all that life of his future, that farm boy's future, which he will then inherit from the father. Since this is what we are taught in our relationship with God now, we are taught the ways of love, the ways of offering our life to the other, the ways of mercy, the way of joy, the way of peace. All these things are in our future, but we have to learn these things through doing our chores now. And sometimes we rebel against that, like a farm boy. You know, we don't want to do those chores. And yet in our prayer life, in our reading of the scriptures, we are learning the ways of our inheritance. We are learning to work the land, to dwell in a relationship with God that fills us with a future full of joy, which we celebrate in this Christmas season. A reading from the first letter of Peter. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. By his great mercy, he has given us a new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, and into an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, kept in heaven for you, who are being protected by the power of God through faith for a salvation ready to be revealed in the last time. In this you rejoice, even if now for a little while you have had to suffer various trials, so that the genuineness of your faith, being more precious than gold that, though perishable, is tested by fire, may be found to result in praise and glory and honor when Jesus Christ is revealed. Although you have not seen him, you love him. And even though you do not see him now, you believe in him and rejoice with an indescribable and glorious joy, for you are receiving the outcome of your faith, the salvation of your souls. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.